evening, everyone, and thank you so much for coming out. Whoa, I didn't mean to put the operatic training to use there. That was boomy. I'm really, really excited to present my, hopefully, final recital of my doctoral degree this evening. And in true Cuban fashion, I'm running late, which is excellent, a little past the 6:30 time. This evening, I'm really, really happy to have so many people joining me and so many familiar faces, including some of what I refer to as my chickadees, my students that are here from Coleman. Before I get started, I need to do my Emmy award-winning speech thanking my family and friends first and foremost. I'm not gonna cry this early in the recital. What you all have done for me throughout everything. I will never have enough words to really tell you thank you enough. To Michael Paddock and David Matthews, not only for the beautiful flowers that are in the sanctuary this evening, but for opening your home and making sure that I can make it through this. To Mr. Jim Connors, the principal cellist of the Florida Orchestra that made time for me. Literally, I cannot thank you enough. To Nancy Callahan, Bonnie Givens, Mary Beth Corcoran, Pastor John, Pastor Nicole, Beth Debevoise, the recording team, and I'm sure so many people from the Palmacia Presbyterian Church community. Can't say thank you enough. To the community of educators in Hillsborough County, I can't be more proud to be part of the county that created this opportunity and so many experiences that have been given to me. To my professors watching from South Carolina, I hope I make you proud. To my collaborative pianist, Mr. Jeff Total, for joining me this evening and just being an absolutely fantastic friend in the meantime as well. And most of all, to my students. I'm an ugly crier too, so I can't do this. Plus, with the humidity, my hair, my mom has already pointed out at least 8 times. Thankfully, I won't get the LA looks with the spit shine to get it going. To my students, I wake up every morning excited to see my chickadees. I love you all to pieces. I hope that I put an example to what I talk about on a daily basis, being brave and making mistakes and making them loud and proud. I hope you enjoy this recital, and I hope you get to see your teacher anxious for once and being stressed out for once instead of you all playing in tune or using the right posture, which tomorrow we'll get to that. So in the meantime, let me know if my posture's bad. This recital is titled Widening the Circle. This has many meanings for me. The last time that I was in the sanctuary playing a recital, I called it Full Circle. And much like life has a funny way of surprising you. Anytime that you think there's not more to offer, suddenly that circle gets wider. This is inspired by the pieces I've visited, but haven't necessarily played in their full. By incorporating the lessons I've learned throughout my entire education, and most importantly, the philosophy that informs my teaching by constantly widening the circle and including more people and giving them a voice. This is the church where my parents were married at, where I attended before I was even born, where I was baptized, and where I'll get married. My role as a music educator here is to constantly widen the circle and advocate for those that can't widen it themselves. To me, this recital and this degree is more than a piece of paper. It is a platform that will allow me to fight for those that don't have a voice. I find that instrumental in music education. That pun was fully intended, so you can laugh at it, help my ego. Thank you, because if I cry the whole recital, that's not cute either. The first piece, as I settle in, is called Seven Brothers. Family music, but a little wonkier, much like my family, no offense. Family is where it starts for me, and it is my origin point in this circle. My heritage, the sacrifices my family constantly made for me, and their love is what makes this all possible. Now, because I have students present, I can't ugly cry too much, and also, I have to be a teacher in the same time. So, this piece has 7 movements. Seven Brothers is essentially a book. The author is Mantas Savickas. He's a Lithuanian composer, and this music is wild, much like my family. This has 7 chapters in it. For my students, Those seven chapters, we don't clap in between each of them. Instead, you'll get a little signal from me. It's very, very subtle. It's called a Bartok pizzicato. Very, very subtle, so you have to listen closely. It's made by pulling the string so it slaps against the fingerboard. Between each of the seven brothers, you're gonna hear eight of those Bartok pizzicatos. The first one after I introduce the whole family, and a Bartok pizz after every brother. I hope that you enjoy Seven Brothers, the first piece of my recital.
Thank you. seems to be a family therapist.
The next piece is actually one that I became obsessed with. I'm a student in middle school. Notice I have to use the voice with my students. It doesn't work otherwise. If I use it at my parents, when I was in middle school, it becomes a little weirder. They get it though. So when I was in middle school, my mom and dad lugged this really, really nasty blue cello case that I had. That was awful, and the latches didn't work. And it weighed like 10 tons, and the cello inside it weighed like 12 tons. And I had the opportunity of getting a chance to see a man by the name of Mark Summer. Mark Summer is a fantastic cellist. He's also one of the founding members of the Turtle Island String Quartet. This is a man that is pretty much obsessed with like alternative genres. He's a guitarist as well. And he wrote a piece called Julio. I had the opportunity to play some really, really bad Suzuki Book 2 minuet, like awful, mom nod your head, dad nod your head, how awful was it? Again, my students need to see this more often. We all start out awful and then we get better. And he was so kind. And I literally remember Mark Summer being like, wow, that is definitely an opinion you had on that music, which now looking back on it is, I don't know if that's a good opinion, but still, he was so incredibly kind. And this piece is something that I became obsessed with and always wanted to play. I've played it a few times before, but in particular, I picked this one for my students because I think we need to do something a little less than just classical, maybe something a little more rock inspired, which connects to this circle as well. My family is famous for my mom and her sisters singing at every event a rendition of Blue Bayou that is musical. See, I'm not insulting you, it's musical. They're laughing. That should give you a hint. It's sort of. I'll be dead after this recital, so if I don't show up tomorrow to work, you know where to find me. On my dad's side of the family, though, and my grandfather, we have my dad, who's a guitarist, that was a rock guitarist in a band, and my grandfather, who plays more of the classical and the Spanish-style guitar. So guitar is something that I've been around for my whole entire life. So what more of a fitting piece than one inspired by some guitar playing? Again, for my students in particular, you're gonna see me do some wild stuff. And by see me do some wild stuff, I mean you're gonna see me do some stuff I already used you as guinea pigs for in class to make sure I wasn't nervous, and yet it didn't work. And it is a piece called Julio that involves me treating the cello a little bit more like a guitarist, sometimes like a drummer too. You'll see me pick up my bow, drop it back down, and hopefully not pass out in the process. I hope you enjoy Julio by Mark Summer.
Thank you.
Finally, I get a little bit nervous because I finally get to share the stage with a friend. Mr. Jeff Chodal is my collaborative pianist for the evening and is a wonderful friend of mine. I trapped Mr. Chodal into playing this recital. And he's been a really, really fantastic friend and has seen me stress out between an hour drive to Tarpon or your hour drive here more times than we can count. Actually, both of us have been stressed. I shouldn't make a light of that beast of a piano part too. The next piece we'll be playing is Brahms' E minor cello sonata. This is a piece that constantly gets played at undergraduate recitals, including by me, and constantly gets played poorly. Hopefully that'll be a little different tonight, but this is one of Brahms' masterworks in his earlier career, and there are some fun facts that I would love to share about this piece that are particularly entertaining, especially if you know nothing about the jolly, jolly, happy man that Brahms was. There's sarcasm there. Brahms is from Hamburg, which at this point in time reminds me that I really want a burger, but that's not the time or the place. It's written between 1862 and 1865. Brahms said of this piece that the piano should be a partner, often leaning, often watchful and considerate partner, but it should under no circumstance assume a purely accompanying role. This makes sense because Brahms was a pianist too, so of course he would want to share the limelight, and so he did. So the first premiere of this piece was actually in a salon with Brahms' friends. He wrote this piece for a friend, and the butchering of the German is about to happen. It's Josef Gansbacher, who performed the cello part with Brahms on the premiere. Well, most excellently, Gansbacher complained that he could not hear his cello throughout the entire performance. To which Brahms replied, and I quote, "Lucky for you, too." But in German. Brahms' cello sonata. This is three movements, the first of which I've described to my students as dark chocolate for the cello. The second movement, which is a minuet and a trio, a little bit sassy, aren't we all sometimes? And the last movement, a really, really fiery, fiery, fiery ending. So I hope you enjoy. Yes.
Brahms in his duo sonatas, be they for cello or piano, clarinet, piano, right, violin, would often title them sonata for piano and violin. So
the order.
The piano gets top billing.
Should I book it? Oh yeah.
Thank you.
where I talk about the last part of the program. I need to get a sip of water. In particular, what's fun about the Brahms is that it's the perfect opportunity to revisit an old friend. Like I said at the beginning of the piece, long ago, this piece is one that's often put in undergraduate recitals, and it's your first taste of a really, really, really complicated cello part. And certainly the piano part is formidable as well. To come in to revisit it at a later point in life is like meeting a friend again after years of not being connected and getting to know it again and widening the circle even further. It's funny because at Coleman, not only am I still teaching at the same school that I went to, but I get to see some of my former teachers still teaching alongside still teaching. Mr. Cohen is in like his 32nd year of teaching, I'm convinced. Now, these kids are born in 2007 and beyond, so they won't remember this, but in Mr. Cohen's classroom at Coleman is when the TVs turned on 9/11. And I was alive at that time. Don't do the math. So getting the opportunity to not only work at the school that I went to invite at the Great American Teach-In today, my former teacher, Mr. Bossert at Plant Over, to have my chickadees get a chance to experience the same thing, maybe one day you too will make a tragic mistake of doing a graduate degree and have a very stressful recital in a church one day too, maybe this church. Or maybe that instrument will take you many places, many, many wonderful places that you couldn't have imagined. And maybe you'll still be stressed, but at least you'll get a chance to express it through the music. The next piece up is based off of Argentinian tango and jazz rhythms, actually. Astor Piazzolla composed this piece, Le Grand Tango, and it's cool that I have my dance partner here ready to go.
I know it's hard, but please resist the urge to dance in the aisle.
And if you do, at least use some hips. This piece, much like a tango and much like life, takes many twists and turns. Some of those turns, a little bit more passionate when you have the younger energy. That's gone from me, but aside from the point, sometimes it slows down and there are more romantic moments that are more tender and gentle. In particular, this tango for me is something special, because it's been one of my dream pieces that I've never gotten a chance to perform. So this is the first time to really play a piece I haven't touched. In particular, this piece has been not only a dance, but also a little bit of a battle. About a year ago, I finally had the chance to come home, back from my hometown, from South Carolina, after getting a chance to meet so many friends and make so many new experiences and learn so much. About in my first year of my doctoral degree, I woke up one morning and everything changed. My body was on fire. I was in pretty much excruciating pain, and there was no explicable reason why. After running through a series of tests and diagnosis, I got hit with a big ol' doozy. I was diagnosed with celiac disease, which is the saddest one because it takes away bread, and I love bread. I'm Cuban. I don't get bread. I get rice, but not bread. Now I get sad, heavy, sad, sad bread. Hashimoto's thyroiditis, which is a condition that attacks my thyroid and creates a real fun time for anybody that knows all the functions of the thyroid. And they put me on medication that didn't quite work. And my joint pain kept on getting worse and worse, and I noticed that my mobility in my hands particularly was affected pretty badly. So when I made the decision to come home, not only was it to make sure that I could come home and teach and get back into the real world and put my knowledge to use, especially my knowledge from the University of South Carolina String Project, where I had chickadees of my own there, not as special, as much as I love them too. I shouldn't say that, I love them too. But now I get chickadees of my own. And had an opportunity to go to a rheumatologist who finally diagnosed me with rheumatoid arthritis about a year ago. This disease is brutal. I've been blessed because I have a warrior mom who deals with the same disease. Watching my mom is a fantastic example of stress. Stress thrown at you and dealing with it in a way that is not only graceful, but inspiring, was a positive role model. Throughout the many medications, including injections that I have to give myself, thankfully, I'm able to get through this recital and play and share something that I feel is very, very important. And more than that, again, is that demonstration of bravery for my own chickadees. So this tango in particular is for my mom. Thank you for teaching me how to dance, even though I'm not very good at it.
Thank you.
have one more thing to share, if you don't mind, and I promise it's less than 2 minutes. I played a song for Mom, so I've got to play one for Dad. And also, it's one that comes with a little bit of a story. Growing up, my grandmother lived with us. My grandmother was feisty. That's an understatement. Both of my grandmothers were, frankly. They were spirited, they were lively. And in particular, I wanted to play one song that was special to, especially my dad, right, to remember many of the loved ones that couldn't be here tonight, to see how much they made an impact on my life. This song also comes with a little bit of a tearjerker. I've played this just about every important event. It's one that's special for my father, especially since it was his mother's favorite song. And the joke about this piece is it's Schubert's Ave Maria, accompanied by my whole entire family's tears, and probably mine too. The last piece of my recital, I cannot thank you all for helping me widen the circle a little bit more. And I can't wait to share and show you how much wider we can go, and how much wider the wonderful musicians I get to work with on a daily basis will widen the world and make it so much better of a place. This evening and for witnessing me ugly cry like a Kardashian. I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening. Please be safe. Please be safe on your ride home, especially. I know there was some rain earlier, and thank you again for coming out.